Hi, good morning, my dear students. Once again, welcome back to our new episode of social science, that is geography. In previous classes, we discussed about the fourth chapter of geography, that is hydrosphere. And I hope all are fine and take care. So let us welcome back once again to the new episode of social science geography, fourth chapter hydrosphere. Okay. So in previous classes, we studied about atmosphere, lithosphere, and biosphere. Okay, sorry, atmosphere and lithosphere we discussed in the previous classes. Okay, so today we are focusing on the hydrosphere. Okay, hydrosphere is the sphere of water. The word hydro refers to water. Okay, so we know that 71% of our earth is comprised of water. 71% of our earth is covered by water bodies. We can see four oceans are there, namely Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, and Arctic Ocean. Okay. So, in previous classes, we already studied the different types of water bodies. They are oceans, sea, gulf, bay, strait, and isthmus. Once again, listen here. Oceans, sea, Gulf, Bay, Strait, and Isthmus. Okay. Oceans, Sea, Gulf, Bay, Strait, Isthmus. Ocean is comparatively larger water body than sea, and sea are smaller in size. Okay. And Gulf and Bay are some water bodies penetrating to interior part of land. Okay. And strait and isthmus are some shapes made by the water bodies. Okay, so these are the different types of water bodies we already studied in the previous classes. Okay, so here now today we are going to study about the relief features of the water or the ocean floor. Okay, relief features of the ocean floor. You know, on land we can see different types of geographical features like mountains, hills, plateaus, plain regions, desert. Okay, different features we can see on the land region. Likewise, in ocean we can see what? Different geographical features, or we call it as the relief features of the ocean floor. Namely, there are four ocean relief features are there, or physiographies are there. Okay, physiography means body shape. Okay, the structural shape of a object is known as what? Physiography. So here we are discussing about the ocean. Okay, ocean has mainly four body shape or structural shape. We call them continental shelf, and the second one is continental slope, third one is the deep sea plain, and fourth one is the ocean deep. Okay, and the ocean deep is one of the interesting thing, and you know that the deepest point on the ocean is the Mariana Trench. This Mariana Trench is the deepest point on the ocean, that is located in the Pacific Ocean in nearby Philippine Island. Okay, you might have heard about the country Philippines. Okay. Okay. So Mariana Trench, its depth is 11,033 meters, more than the height of the Mount Everest. You know, the height of the Mount Everest is 8,848 only. Here the depth of Mariana Trench is 11,033 meters. Approximately it is 11 kilometers, and we can say the approximate height of Mount Everest is 9 kilometers. So we can dip, if we take Mount Everest and if we dip in the ocean, in the Pacific Ocean, in the Mariana Trench, it will sink. Okay, so that much is the huge depthness of what? Mariana Trench. Okay, and we know that majority ocean waters are saline water. Why ocean waters are saline or salty? The main reason is, you know, the water bodies including rivers and streams and lakes carries what? Different types of minerals to the ocean water or the sea. Okay, that is why sea or ocean water contains the presence of it tastes like what? Salty. Because on the course of the running, while flowing to the sea or ocean, from the mountain onwards, the water carries different types of soil, sand, minerals, okay, salt, many things. So these minerals makes the ocean water salty. Okay. And you might have heard about one Dead Sea nearby Israel, Dead Sea. Okay. If we swim, if we jump into the or dive into the ocean, we will not go down because the salinity, the percentage of salt is very high in the water, in that Dead Sea. You can do the same experiment by yourself. Just to put an egg in a pure water, what you can see that egg will be sinking under the water. Okay, and in another glass, you just take a glass of water with adding 2-3 teaspoons of salt, and you just put a egg on it. What will happen? You can see the egg will be floating. Okay, it will not go down. Because of this same reason is applicable in the Dead Sea. Okay, because of the salinity, the presence of salt is very high in the Dead Sea. Okay. And the temperature and salinity of the ocean water, temperature as well as salinity is different from each and every ocean and sea. Okay. And here you can see a diagram, a data you can see on page number 200. It shows a fact file, saline water bodies of the world. Lake Van, that is in a lake in Turkey, it contains 330% of what? Salinity. Okay. And Dead Sea, it has 300. Lake Sambar in India, 265. Red Sea, that is in Asia and Africa, 240. Okay. And now we are going to study about ocean currents. What is meant by currents? Current means flow. Okay, you, for electricity also sometimes we call it as current. Current means flow of energy. Okay, here ocean current means the ocean water has three types of movements. They are waves, currents and tides. Ocean currents are the regular movement of ocean water from one region to another. So the movement of water from one place to another in a specific manner, in a specific route is known as what? Ocean currents. Okay, and the different types of ocean currents are warm currents, cold currents. Okay, some ocean water movements are very hot and some are very cold. Okay, warm currents originate and flow from the equatorial regions to subpolar regions, whereas cold currents flow in between polar regions and flow towards the equatorial regions. Okay, and on page number 201 you can see different currents of the Pacific Ocean, South Pacific Ocean, North Atlantic Ocean and South Atlantic Oceans, and their different names also you can see in that chart. Okay, so next thing is the tide. Next topic is tide. Okay, tide means periodic rise and fall of sea or ocean water is known as what? Tide. They occur due to gravitational attraction of the moon, gravitational force by the sun, rotation of the earth and centrifugal force of the earth. Okay, so different causes or reasons are there for the tides. Okay, tide means what? The up and down fall of the ocean water. Okay, and there are different types of tides are there, high tide and low tide, and high tide and low tide takes different times. Okay, and spring tide is there. Spring tides take place when the earth, the moon and the sun are in the same straight line, example in during new moon or full moon time. When the spring tides take place, the high tides are the highest and the low tides are the lowest in the shape. Okay, and we can see neap tide also. Neap tides occur on the first quarter and last quarter days in the phase of the moon. You know that moon has different phases are there, different stages are there. Okay, So according to the movement of the moon and the earth, the tides will vary or change. Okay, and let us see what are the uses. What are the uses of the tides? Okay, so mainly there are we can say there are five uses are there for tides. First one, tides help in navigation for big ships during high tides. Okay, navigation means moving and traveling through the oceans or seas are known as navigation. The second one, the tides prevent some extent of freezing sea or ocean water in the coast. So because of this continuous movement of the water or tides, water is not getting what freezed or becoming ice. Okay, it prevents from becoming too frozen. Okay, then third one, tides help us to keep the harbors clean. Okay, because of the movements of the flow of water, it keeps away all the wastes, including solid waste, including maybe plastics. Okay, all these things will be removed away by the tides. They help fishing. They help in fishing. Boat can also go very fast according to the tide also. Okay, and the fifth one is they also help to generate tidal energy. Okay, we are making energy from wind, water, like that. From tide energy, from the tide, the movement of ocean water can also generate what electricity by keeping some devices. Okay, and conservation of oceans, this is very important. Conservation of ocean is very important. Oceans help us many ways, and they are the habitat of millions of marine organisms. Marine means the living beings on the ocean or sea are known as marine. Okay, considering the rate at which the oceans are being contaminated, they may not remain what they should be in the future. Okay, so it depends upon the contamination or pollution. So we want to control the pollution, different types of pollution: soil pollution, air pollution, and water pollution. Okay, the following are the important methods of conservation of oceans. On page number 204, you can see these things. Okay, so there you can see six points are there on page number 204. The following are the important methods of conservation of oceans. First one, oil transportation should be done through pipelines. So there we can prevent the leakage of oils. And if the oils are spilling on the ocean, what will happen? The percentage of the level of oxygen will reduce in the water, and it can cause the death of marine lives or including fish. Okay, nuclear waste should not be dumped into the sea or ocean. Many developed countries, they are putting many electronic as well as technological devices or nuclear waste in the ocean, so that we are polluting deliberately the ocean. Okay, so it should not be happened. Petrochemical industries in the coastal regions must avoid dumping effluents into the sea or ocean. Here effluent means waste. Dumping of any waste near the ports and the harbors must be controlled by the government. Okay, individual or government can also take action against this kind of pollution. So first we should be bothered or aware about these kinds of pollution and its impact. Ore deposition and mineral exploitation along the coast must be controlled. Then last point, exploitation and destruction of beaches must be controlled. So these are the some conservation methods of oceans that we can do to protect our oceans. Okay, I hope you understood this part, and this is the conclusion of this chapter, hydrosphere, and focus on reading. Okay, try to get more knowledge from the textbook. Okay, and moreover, I shall send you related relevant videos connected to this chapter. Till then, take care. Have a nice day. Thank you.